Any guess at what disorder affects 40% of people over the age of 60? It's something called metabolic syndrome, and it doesn't just mean that your metabolism is slow. So what is this syndrome that affects so many people? Welcome to How Wellness Works. Metabolic syndrome, sometimes referred to as Syndrome X, is a metabolic disorder that involves not one, but a cluster of three or more of the following: abdominal obesity, high fasting blood sugar, high triglyceride levels, high blood pressure, or low HDL cholesterol. That's otherwise known as your good cholesterol. Metabolic, in this sense, refers to the processes of your body involved in normal functioning. So if you've been diagnosed with metabolic syndrome, your body is seriously malfunctioning, and you are at risk for serious and possible lethal conditions such as non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, diabetes, heart disease, and stroke. The good news is that this syndrome is almost 100% preventable and modifiable, because the two main causes of metabolic syndrome are, one, being overweight, and two, having a sedentary lifestyle or not exercising, both of which you can have some control over. So not only are there some wonderful lifestyle interventions, dietary modifications, and studied dietary supplements to help if you have metabolic syndrome, it's also perfectly preventable by maintaining an ideal and healthy weight, staying on a consistent exercise regimen consisting of a combination of burst training or high-intensity interval training for belly fat loss, and strength training for blood sugar control, as well as eating a whole foods, plant-strong diet. In fact, there is actually a proven metabolic syndrome diet. First, let's talk about the things to avoid. Processed foods. If it can't run or swim away from you, or it didn't fall off a plant, don't eat it. These foods usually have poor nutritional value and fill you with empty calories that lead to obesity. Instead of processed grains, whole grains like brown rice, quinoa, millet, and oatmeal can provide fiber and have proven benefits for diabetes and heart health. Avoiding this one might surprise you: diet sodas. Since diet sodas contain artificial sweeteners as well as other unhealthy ingredients, you don't want to consume them. Studies show that the consumption of diet soda is associated with significantly greater risk of select incident metabolic syndrome components and type 2 diabetes. Diet sodas are sweet, and when you drink them, your brain thinks there is sugar coming, so your pancreas will release insulin. When there is no sugar to process, insulin is just floating around with nothing to do, and this contributes to insulin resistance, as well insulin being stored as fat. Other things you want to avoid are trans fats. These are fats found in things like cakes, cookies, donuts, crackers, creamer, and margarine, and are artificially produced by adding hydrogen to liquid vegetable oil in order to make it solid. They have the ability to contribute to raising your bad cholesterol and triglycerides. Along with this, avoid refined carbohydrates, because these products in excess can lead to elevated blood sugar and insulin resistance, which of course can lead to diabetes and metabolic syndrome. Let's talk about healthy supplementation. The word supplement in the dictionary means something that completes or enhances something else when it's added to it. So these studied supplements simply enhance a proper diet and lifestyle to help combat metabolic syndrome. Berberine. Berberine is a component of several different plants and has been the subject of many randomized controlled studies. It helps to regulate glucose and lipid metabolism, which directly and positively affect weight management. Chromium helps insulin shuttle blood sugar into cells. In fact, without chromium, insulin cannot work properly. Here's the problem. Due to poor soil quality, most Americans are deficient in this critical nutrient, so supplementation, especially when dealing with metabolic syndrome, might be crucial. Holy basil is a wonderful plant medicine that has been studied in double-blind clinical trials to show significant improvement in blood glucose control and mild improvement in cholesterol levels. This suggests that holy basil supplementation can be a useful and safe way to help control diabetes and complications that result from the diseases like metabolic syndrome. So as we get older, a particular hormone called dehydroepiandrosterone, or DHEA, which is involved in many metabolic processes, does begin to naturally decline and can lead to suboptimal hormone profile that leads to greater risk of insulin resistance and metabolic syndrome in both middle-aged men and women. DHA and EPA, these are the long-chain omega-3 fatty acids found in fish and have a multitude of health benefits, including increased fat burning and improved glucose metabolism. Supplementation can also help decrease the expression of genes involved in fat storage, downregulate genes involved in inflammation, and lower levels of C-reactive protein, which is a marker of inflammation. And finally, bioflavonoids like quercetin, resveratrol, and olive polyphenols have natural anti-inflammatory properties and may offer protection against metabolic syndrome. As you can see, even though this syndrome currently affects over 40% of adults over the age of 60, it doesn't have to. When you know how wellness works, you can employ simple dietary and lifestyle interventions along with studied supplementation to keep you metabolically optimized. If you struggle with metabolic syndrome or know somebody who does, by all means, consider seeing a trained integrative health practitioner like a naturopathic doctor or a functional medicine practitioner or an osteopath to get more individualized guidance. So if you struggle with metabolic syndrome or know somebody who does, like this video and comment below so we can keep the conversation going.